The shortcut slider mimicking the advanced options of Lightroom on desktop and a detailed explanation on how to pop the image by tuning these sliders. Watch the full video on how sharpening and noise reduction work from the detail menu option available in the free Lightroom app. Here's one image of a structure of Petra Jordan where I would like to get more details by sharpening it. Opening Edit and going down to the Detail menu. The three options here, Sharpening, Noise and Color Noise, which we will go through. In Sharpening, adding just a little bit of amount gives you more options, Radius, Detail and Masking. Increasing amount, which basically sharpens the overall image. This works on individual pixels. You can see the before and after. Increasing radius starts affecting the nearby pixels and so on. The detail slider boosts the final details in the picture. It focuses on highlighting the edges it finds in the picture, like the patterns in this image. Masking slider determines the area of the image that sharpening affects. At 0, it sharpens all pixels, the whole image equally. As you increase it, the sharpening will target smaller, more distinct areas. There is a way to visualize the pixels affected. You just need to use two fingers to slide on masking slider. Now you can see the white parts on which the sharpening effect will be applied. So, whatever changes you make in all the sliders above, it affects only the white pixels tuned in the masking slider. Need to be careful while increasing the sharpening as it adds noise to the image unless you want grainy look for artistic purposes. I have a picture of this bird, but when you zoom in, you can notice noise in the image. Now, moving to the noise options. You can just use the noise reduction slider to reduce the grainy look of the image and increase smoothness. Need to balance this with the other sliders below to get a good result. Detail increases the contrast of the pixels which have turned smooth because of the noise removal. Contrast slider makes the big shapes and color differences more noticeable. This makes the larger elements stand out. On this image, if you zoom in on the portrait, you can notice the color noise. This time, we will be using the color noise options. Here, you can notice moving the color noise reduction slider to the right makes the noise monochromatic, basically removes the color. The thing to remember here is more you move this slider, the more grayish the pixels turn, and this reduces the overall saturation. Detail preserves the colors in small groups of pixels. Reducing it will make the colors blend more. Need to be careful while tuning to maintain the balance of the image. Smoothness slider smooths out the colors by making the similar colors larger, basically makes similar color patches blend. Again, need to be careful as if gone too far, some colors might disappear and become neutral. Also going to luminance noise options to remove and make the grain more manageable. An image of bird with lot of color noise, probably because of the higher ISO it was shot with. Removing color noise, adding detail and smoothening the grains a bit. You can also go to luminance options to completely reduce the grainy look. But this also makes the image lose details. Though this may not be the best option here, you can go to sharpening sliders and tune the masking slider to select only certain parts of the bird where the sharpening will be applied so that the sharpening won't bring back the noise on the other parts of the image. Hope these tips would be useful to you all, and subscribe for more photo editing videos. Thanks for watching.